Hello friends, now we will see the questions that comes in your data interpretation. All the question that is based on your line diagram, bar diagram, then pie diagram, and finally your tabular diagram we will cover. So understand whatever the things that is teach here, and then you can refer your books in order to solve more question and to do more practice. So here is a question that is related to your pie diagram. There is a circle which represent various percentage out of 100 that is expend on various sports. So you can see the highest share is of cricket. I guess it is of India, but for India this must be more, right? As compared to hockey, this must be very more. It should be 50% for India. Let's see this question. So there are various type of expenditure that is done on various sports on a particular year, right? So on the basis of this, we are going to solve the question. So the first question is, what percentage of total expenditure is spent on tennis? So tennis is how much? 12% of the total expenditure, right? So you can simply say 12%. Some question will be very simple of data interpretation. You can directly say and you can answer it. And some should need little bit calculation. This is the basic type of question of pie diagram we are doing. Later we will go towards hard question. How much percent less is spent on football than that on cricket? So you know that football is 15%, cricket is 22%, but they ask you with respect to cricket how much it is less. So you have to find out individual amount that is spent on this particular sports. So the total amount is this much. So 22% of total amount is spent on cricket. So you can find out the amount that is spent on cricket. 2, 4, 6. So this, after you solve, you come to know the answer, right? So 22 into 18. This comes out to be 396,000. And on football, it is 15%, so 15 by 100 into 18,000,30456. After doing this, you come to know about football, right? 15 into 8. This comes out to be 27,000,000. So how much is the difference between them? How much is the difference between them? You have to calculate this. So the difference between them is of this much money. Okay, this is the amount by which it is varying, and what percentage it is asking this amount is of cricket. So cricket total amount is 396,000,000 4 times 0. So this you can cut. I guess 10 is added extra. 4. Yeah, correct. So this should be like 10 should be there, and this must be cut. Okay, so this will be 126/3960. So we have to find out the value of it. This also cuts. So 126/326. You have to find out this value. So 396. So this value comes out to be 0.318. so 31.8%. You have to multiply it by 100. So 31.8% is the amount that is less that of cricket, right? So this how you need to calculate. Some part you have to do calculation and some not. The total amount is this much. The amount spent on basketball exceed on tennis is, so basketball is where this 14% and tennis is 12%. So you can, the amount spent on basketball expend, so it is 2%. So 2% more is there. So 2% of this one, you can simply find out. 2 means what? 2/100 into 18,000,000 0.04620 cuts. This comes out to be 36. This much amount is spending is less as compared to tennis, right? Basketball exceed by this much amount than tennis. So this how you need to calculate it. Okay. So here is a question in front of us. The table is provided to us. We will solve all the type of question, pie diagram, then line diagram, then tabular form table. So all the questions I try to cover up. Apart from that, you also have to find questions of data interpretation. You have to first see the question, then come to the table so that you can analyze the question and then frame your idea. It is no use by just seeing table first, right? So first you have to go and see the question. So this is a typical production of cars by a company chart from 1989 to 1994. Okay, so there you can see that in years, and there is a type, right? PQRST, these are the types of cars which are produced in particular year, right? So we will find out following data from various things. You can see that this addition is addition of all the type of car. Suppose a company is there, it produce Swift, it produce Honda City, it produce other car like Maruti Eco. Similar wise, these are the type of cars and these are their number of production in a particular year. So let's see the first question, what they ask us to find out. Okay, in which year the production of cars of all type taken together was approximately equal to the average of the total production during the period. So in which year the production of cars of all the types taken together was approximately equal to the average of total production during that particular year. So you have to find the average of all the type of, right, all the type of car, and you have to see which year it is very near or near approx to the average production. Okay, so you can see the entire production in this 5 years is 476, right? Total production, every year production is given to you, and this production is for how many years? You have to see, you have to see for number of years, right? So this is the total car that was produced in those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years, right? So 476 car were produced in 6 years. So you will simply divide it by 6, you will get an average what number of cars they manufacture every year. That comes out to be 79.33. so where you can see the average production or the production of car near approx 79. So 79 means 80. So 80, can you see anywhere? Yes, you can see. So which year is this in which the it is equivalent to the average production of a company? So this year is 1993. So you will mark 1993 in this question. Okay, let's see the next question now. Next question is, in which year the total production of car of type P and Q together was equal to the total production of car of type R and S. Okay, so they are asking in which year the total production of P and Q is equivalent to R and S. Okay, so you have to calculate separately for this. So in 1989, okay, I draw 1 minute. If we draw like this, okay, so this is 1989. In 1989, we can see P and Q, right? So P and Q together producing how much cars? P plus Q together producing how much car? 24, right? In 1989, 1990 they are producing 30. Similarly, if we go ahead, 1991 they are producing 30. Okay, this is for 1991. You should write like this. This is for 1991. And 1992 comes out to be 29. Then 3 comes out to be 33. And 4 comes out to be 20. Okay. Similarly, you will make for R plus S, R plus S. For 1989, it will be 25. 21 plus 4 for 1989. Then 17 plus 6, this comes out to be your number of car produced in 1990, right? 1990, you produce 23. Similarly, every year car of RS and S you will add for 1991. 1992, it will be 31. And 1993, it will be 33. And in 1994, it will be 94. So, it was asked in which year both the production of P plus Q and R plus S were equal. So, you can see 33, 33. Both production is equal in which year? 1993. So, you will mark which year? 1993. So, that option is not there. So, you will type none of the above. Okay. So, answer is 1993. Okay, let's see the next question. During the period 1989 to 1994, in which type of car was continuous increase in production? Okay, so you have to see the table. Okay, you have to see the table and you have to see which car is continuously its production is increasing over the years. So you can see 8, 20, then there is a decline, so it cannot be. 16, 10, again decline, cannot be. 4, 17, again decline. 4, 6, okay, increasing. 10 increasing, 16 increasing, 20 increasing, 31 increasing, means this is continuously increasing, right? And that was asked to us in question. In which year, which graph clearly show that there is a continuous increase in the production. So, the answer comes out to be S type. So, S you will mark. So, S is the answer. Okay. Let's move forward. Production of which type of car was 25% of the total production of all the types of car during 1993? So, they ask you the number production of which type of car was 25% of the total population of all the type of cars during 1993. Okay, so you have to find out 1993, we are here. And there, 1 minute, let me clear this. Okay, 1993, they are asking, we are in 1993 now. 1993, they are asking 25% of total production is equivalent to which type of car. So, 25%, 25 by 100 of total 1993 cars, that is 80. So, 1 by 4 value comes out to be 20. So, which type of car is having value 20 or very near to 20, you have to see. So you can see in 1993, okay. So in 1993, the 25% part of the total production is made by which car? Which car? 21, 12, 20, okay. So we got that S is the answer. S is a car which is exactly 20, right? Exactly 20 or 25% of the total car produced in 1993. So the answer comes out to be S. Okay. Next question. The percentage increase in total production of all types of car in 1992 to that in 1991. Okay. So you have to see what was the percentage increase in car from 1991 to 1992. So you can see there is increase. From 75, it is becoming 90. So, how much is the increase? 15 is the increase. And on what number it got increased? What was the initial number or which number you put from your pocket, right, to get this? So, you invested 75, right? This 15 is increasing on 75. So, 15 by 75 you do, it comes out to be 3 by 15, 16, 5, then 15, 3, 1 by 5, So 1 by 5 comes out, and now you have to convert it in percentage. So you will multiply it by 100. This comes out to be 20%. So 20% is the increase. 20% is the increase from 1991 to 1992. The answer will be, answer for this will be 20%. Okay, next question. Okay, so we are done with that first type of question. I hope you enjoyed, and the questions are quite simple. Just you need to understand the concept behind it and see the questions, right? And everything become very simple. Just analyzing thing is important. Okay, okay, so here is a question in front of us. First, we have to see the given data that is provided to us. Then we will move towards the question that comes to your examination. Okay. So you can see that there is a graph not tabular form data that is provided to you. Okay. Study the table and answer the question. The number of 5 types of cycle manufactured by a company over the year is given below. Right. So every year, the number of cycle that is manufactured by a company is given below. From the above data, you have to see following things and check for it. Okay, now we will see the question or the type of question that they are asking in this type of tabular form questions. Okay, so but before that, just first analyze that there is a number of year, there is a type of cycle in particular year, right? So that cycle is provided to you that in 1997 there is A cycle which manufacture was 200, B cycle which manufacture was 150, and so on. So, and in 1998, the cycle production of A was 150, and the same time kind of data is applicable for all. So, this is just initial analysis that you need to do before actually jumping or solving the questions, right? So now we will see the type of question that comes in such type of questions. Okay. So here you can see the first question it is in front of you that asks for what was the approximate percentage of increase in production of D type of cycle from 1998 to they are asking 2000. Okay, from 1998 to 2000, you have to see what was the increase in production. Okay, what was the increase in production that you have to check and find out. Okay, so let's go to the next question. D type, so D is there. 1998 you have to check from. Okay, to the present data, in 1998 to 2000 they ask, right? 1998 to 2000 they ask us. 1998 is in front of you, is in front of you, that is 105, right? And 2000 is 125. So they ask you what was the approximate percentage of increase in the production of D type of cycle from 1998 to 2008. You can see there is an increase of how much? 20 cycles, right? And this 20 cycle was increased on what number? 105. So 20 by 105, when you do 20 by 105, so after solving this you will get the answer. Okay, into 100 you have to do, because you have to convert it in percentage. This when you solve 20 by 105, this comes as a fraction. So 5 table, as you know, 4, 21. So 4 by 21 into 100 you have to solve. After solving this, this comes out to be 19%. So 19% is your answer for the first question. Let's see the next question. In the case of which type of cycle was total production of the given 5 year was maximum? Okay, so you have to see which type of cycle is having the maximum production. So what you have to check, in case of which type of cycle was the total production of the given 5 years is maximum, so So you have to calculate for all the 5 years and the type of cycle. So first, a type of cycle you will see. So you will add all those. 200 plus 150 plus 180, that comes out to be 350 plus 380 plus 20, that comes out to be 400 plus 30, 430 plus 100, 530 plus 550, 200, 600 something, and this comes out to be, okay, the entire production comes out to be 945 for A type. For B we will do 5, okay. This after adding 585, that is 13, 7, that is 20 plus 6, 26, 26 plus 8, 26 plus 8, you can do 34. 845 for the next year. Okay. Now for this you can calculate in the similar way. 10. And this comes out to be 8, 9, 18. 1 minute. Second, sorry sir. 9 plus 9, that is 18, 20, 23, 5 goes there, 5, 20. Nearly this you can solve. 5, 1 goes there. Then adding this, and 11, 13, 13 plus 5, it is 16. 1 carries, 565. Similarly, you can solve for this. This comes out to 5, 5, 5, 18, 1, and after solving, this comes out to be 375. So, which cycle production you can see the maximum? That is A cycle. Okay, so A will be your answer. So, the maximum production happens for A in those 5 years. Next question. What was the percentage drop in production of A type cycle from 1997 to 1999? Okay. 1997 data of A is 200. 1999 is 180. So what is a drop? 20 is a drop. On what number it got dropped? Initial number 200. You always find out the percentage increase or decrease on the initial number. This comes out to be 10%. Okay, 1 by 10 it comes out to be, then you again multiply it by 100. So this comes out to be 10%. The answer will be 10%. Here answer is 10%. Next question. The production of each type of cycle in 2001 was what percentage of production of B type of cycle? B type of in 2000 year. Okay, so production of each type of cycle in 2001, okay, was what percentage of the production of B type in 2000? So 2000 you have to calculate B, total cycle of B in 2000. Okay, so here you can see 160 was the number, right? 160 was the number that was of B in 2000. What else is asked to us? The production of each type of cycle in 2001, okay, was what percentage? So production of each type of cycle in 2001 is there. Production of each type of cycle. Okay, there is a mistake in question. It is not each, it is E type of cycle. Okay, E type of cycle in 2001 was what percentage of production of B type 2000. E type you can see in 2001, that value comes out to be, E type in 2001, its value comes out to be 80, right? 80. So 80 is E type in 2001, right? Upon it asks what percentage of E type in 2001 is equivalent to B type in 2000, here. So 2B type is 160. So after you do this, this comes out to be 1 by 2 percentage to convert, multiply 100. This comes out to be 50%. So the answer for this will be 50%. Okay. So 50. Thank you.